up, y'all? I'm Toya from My Froggy Stuff and a longtime Breyer fan. Today, I'm going to share with you some of my favorite Breyer Craft products. There's a variety of Breyer Craft and Activity kits. Look, I'm even on the packaging. On the back of each one, we can scan the QR code and get crafty. This is the Surprise Horse Paint and Play. This is a surprise bag, so we don't know which model is inside. I think these are absolutely perfect for like stocking stuffers or birthday party goodie bags. And crafting on the go, because everything we need to paint our horse is inside. On the back, there is a picture of all of the models, including a Mustang, an Arabian, an Andalusian, and a quarter horse. Let's open it up and take out our paint, our brush, a guide, and our horse. I love the painting tips guide. It has a lot of useful information, like optional supplies, pictures of horses for inspiration, markings, and close-ups. Our paint colors are brown, black, and white. Our brush has a pretty nice tip, and our model is totally ready to be painted. But first, we might need a few things from home, like a cup of water, a paint palette, or double paper plates to mix paint, paper towels, clear nail polish to make the eyes shine, and when you're finished, you can always choose to use a spray-on sealant to protect your project. Now let's get started. I'm gonna go with a little bit of brown paint and begin painting the body, adding just a little bit of paint at a time to try and get nice, even strokes. Allow it to dry, then add a second coat. Once that dries, I just take a little time to do some touch-ups. Let's go ahead and paint the mane and tail brown as well. I painted one thin coat to look like a lighter brown. Let's mix a little brown and a touch of black so we can lightly dry brush shadows. We're just gonna go to all the little areas that have a little bit of a crease and add a little bit of a shadow. I'm using brown paint to blend those shadows and smooth it out. All right, that's looking pretty decent. I want to add a facial marking, so maybe we can do a star. Of course, we can use white paint, but I like to just scratch off some of the paint because he is white underneath. And that'll give us a nice clean line, especially since we want it so small. Use black paint for the eyes and a teeny tiny dot of white paint. I'm adding some thin brown lines to the hooves. I used watered down paint and it created some nice shading. Allow it to dry. We can spray it with a sealant to protect it and add clear nail polish to the eyes to give them a little shine. But that is completely optional. It is up to you. And if we want to take it a step further, let's use recycled paperboard, a cut wooden dowel, scrapbook paper, and acrylic paint. Cut the paperboard into 4x6 inch rectangles. Stack and glue several layers together to make a board. Glue on scrapbook paper. I chose a paper with a sand print. I'm using some of the leftover paint to paint a small wooden dowel white. Use acrylic paint to add stripes to make a pole. Glue the horse onto the base. I glued mine so the muzzle is right in the center. I place my cell phone in front so the back is resting on the horse, and we're gonna glue the pole right in front. So it looks like a small diorama of a horse about to jump over a ground pole, but we can also use it as a cell phone holder, making this project cute and functional. However you choose to decorate your surprise horse, be sure to have fun and get creative. To learn more about Breyer and the real horses who inspire us, visit the Breyer website at www.breyerhorses.com. And we will see you next time. Bye!